The Oracle of Omaha, Warren Buffett, said he made a mistake with one of his investments, Delta, by accidentally building a 10% stake in the company. Take a listen to his exclusive interview with Becky Quick earlier today.
Delta made an appearance, I don't know, 3 weeks ago or some investment conference, and they announced they'd bought in 26 or 27 million shares and borrowed $1 billion to do it. Well, I like that in two aspects. They bought in 4% of their stock, so all of a sudden we own 4% more of Delta than we had the day before. I like the fact they were willing to borrow $1 billion to accelerate a stock repurchase program. But what I didn't realize was that purchase had taken us over 10%, so I was already in territory that I didn't plan to get, so I just decided to buy a whole lot more stock.
Delta is now just about one of the only airliners sitting in the green so far this month, so will this accident by Warren Buffett pay off, Pete?
Well, he's still willing to put more money, even if he found out by accident, right? And I think that says something. I think it says something about...
Do you care about what that says?
I think it has some meaning behind it. I don't think Warren's just going to throw money just because he'd made a mistake. I think there's a little bit more thought process than that. He might not have articulated that very much, but I think so. Also, Mel, when you look at of the names right now, no exposure to the issues with the Boeing. So basically it puts them in a very interesting spot. Now, I'm already in Southwest, which has a lot of exposure, or more exposure. UAL, I like, less exposure. And then DAL, I look at Delta. I think of the names right now, that one's the best position to go higher faster.
Last night, Scott was the host while you were you were flying back. And I said, I welcome you back. It is good to have you back, by the way, at 5:30 in the
it's
afternoon.
The second time you've done
it. Well, no, it's important.
I'm that happy.
I know.
But I'll say this, you
I'm
know,
like
Southwest Air.
No, I'm at all, Mel, come on.
To your point, gave lousy guidance the other day, but the stock was up 2.25% on that lousy guidance. As we say, you know, we play poker from time to time. That's called a tell, Mel. I know you don't play that often, but we play, and that's a tell. Bad news, good stock action. Stock up again today. A little more expensive than Delta, but I think some beta is in LUV.
Yeah. What, do you like the airlines, Phil?
It's a classic pro-cyclical trade here. So it goes back to the point I was making with Dan before. What does the yield curve say? Is the yield curve saying we're heading into something sinister, where growth is going to slow? Or is it a classic financial condition story that makes things really easy? The stock market has done incredibly well over the past decade because financial conditions are easy. So it's all about this fork in the road now. Is the yield curve telling us something about slow growth? Then it's no.
Right.
But our view is it's a financial condition story, path of least resistance higher.
Like
so the pro-cyclical
like
works.
Nice. Airlines have helped to put the brakes on the transports in the past month, down 7%. But our next guest says the group is about to truck on higher. Let's go off the charts with Rob Sluymer, Fundstrat Advisors. He's over at the Plasma. Hey, Rob.
Hey, Melissa. So let's take a look at the transports. It's a big concern for a lot of people. Things have been slowing down. The market's been pulling back. But let's just take a look at the bigger picture, because I think it's really important to stay focused on the long-term market cycle. And again, we look at this 200-week, this four-year moving average as a proxy for the secular trend for the market. Again, back in 16, we had a major inflection point off that 200-week, that four-year average. And again, we saw that at the beginning, at the end of 2018, beginning of 19. So we still believe what we're looking at is a broader market cycle taking off here, and that we're just into a period of consolidation. We had a massive move in January and February. A lot of these stocks are just consolidating and unwinding a lot of their overbought condition. Now, the concern is we have all this weak relative performance. That's not a great sign. We always want to stay in the leading areas of the market, and that relative performance is weak. But I do think as we get into the second quarter, there's going to be a lot of backing and filling, a lot of contra trades, a lot of mean reversion trades, and I think we're getting very close to one of those points right here. So if we look at the transports on a very short-term basis, this is a daily chart. That's that menacing 200-day moving average that everybody's concerned about, that the transports can't get above. But I think the key point, the one that I think is most noteworthy, is that this RSI indicator, a trading indicator, a daily short-term momentum indicator, is starting to bottom out. So after 4 to 5 to 6 weeks of trading sideways, we think that a number of these names, after the pause, after the concern, after the bearishness comes back in, are getting ready to go. So what do you want to own? Again, we want to come back to the leading names in the leading part of the market, and that rails continue to screen very well for us. So for the fast money traders, for the faster guys that can be tactical, we think there's a buy right here on UNP. It's just starting to come off of some pretty key support here. You've had that momentum unwinding, and when you look at the relative performance, it's still in a long-term relative uptrend. That's not a straight line by any means, but there is a straight line there, and that's where it's starting to bounce. We want to own UNP. And the other name we want to own, still the same group, but starting to turn here. Here's CSX, just coming off that 200-day, sideways for 4 to 5, 6 weeks. It's a pretty timely setup. We think the market goes higher here over the next couple of weeks.
All right, Rob, why don't you come on over? Join us here at the desk. Evan will bring the chair in.
Great music.
Thank you, Evan.
No, it's not good music.
No, it's
I love the music. What's that?
It's good enough.
We used to use like, real game show music, and then we got in trouble.
So I love that.
The fake enough. Music
this is
now.
Great fake music.
But it still conveys the point. He's here now.
Yeah.
Is this a good sign for the overall markets? I mean, if one is a believer of Dow theory, and people out there, some are. So.
Right. So our overall view is we think that the lows that we saw in December were a cycle low, very similar to what we saw in the beginning of 16. It's up for debate. I'm sure a lot of people disagree with that, but that's our view. This huge run off the first quarter lows or the Q4 lows, and now markets begin to churn and consolidate. So you're going to get backing and filling and backing and filling. So I think, again, the call is these things are going to pull back, but they're not going to break down. So longer term, I think that the market just works through this consolidation and eventually moves higher.
So, Rob, I love your charting work, but you just cherry-picked the two best-looking charts in the transports. You picked that. CSX, UNP, NSC, the rails look great. But there's a lot of divergence. We just spent some time. The airlines look horrible. FedEx looks horrible.
Yes.
The truckers look horrible.
Yeah. Not all of them.
Not all of them. There you go. I totally.
Landstar. I mean, I'm just saying. But they,
ODFL looks fine.
Night Transportation.
J.B. Hunt's pulled right back.
Okay, guys. So J.B. Hunt looks horrible. I looked at that one, too. Now, I'm just saying that there's lots of divergences there, though. I mean, so.
So the question is, are we seeing a massive failure in risk assets in general? Right. We came off the lows. Everything went up after crashing in the fourth quarter. And is this just a rolling over bear market bounce or not? I don't think it is. And honestly, we're not going to know for many, many weeks, not until the market sort of works through this. But if we're right, of course, we think we're right, then what we are seeing is just a consolidation, a rotation. Transports have pulled back. You've got daily buys, short-term buys on all these daily indicators on truckers, on rails. Of course, I'm going to pick the best names. Why would I put you in the worst names? But if you really want a dumpster dive, if you look at names like XPO, and even FedEx and UPS, I think they're trying to bottom out. So I'm going to take the opposite side of that. I think they're going higher.
No, I mean, but dumpster diving is important because it actually speaks to risk. It speaks to the fact that, okay, things might be better 3-6 months out. And I actually think that a FedEx or a UPS
You would rather a dumpster dive as opposed to buying
those
marquee
stocks are going to break out. That UNP, that CSX, if things are like, you know, they're going to be making new highs very soon. But I guess at some point at FedEx down at 176, you know, you may get a lot of bang for your buck. That was a stock that was above $200 6 months ago.
What would you rather? Let's just say FedEx versus Union Pacific.
So first of all, this dumpster dive thing concerns me.
Why?
It just sounds extraordinarily
dirty.
Dangerous, and it's dirty.
Unsanitary.
And those, like the mice and the things are in it.
Rats.
Rats.
Vermin.
Food.
My question would be this. The S&P 500 is about 4% off its all-time high. We agree with that. That's just math, right? Federal Express made an all-time high of 275 January. In the beginning of 2018. Why is it 35% lower now with the S&P 4%? Is it a Federal Express thing, or does it speak to a much bigger problem? I don't know the answer, but it's worth having a conversation. And I would say, I think it's actually rolling over again to the downside.
So that means,
if I'm answering your question,
would you rather?
I had to get that out there.
Union Pacific.
Yeah. I forgot we're playing the game. Because
like
usually we have the graphics when we play the game.
We did have the graphic.
Traded or failed?
We had it when I asked the question.
Sorry. Guys, I think there's a possibility.
Have it again. Rather.
FedEx has already had a major cycle correction. From 2018, everything that was cyclical got washed out. And those were major lows. And now we're just sort of working through a bottoming process.
Absolutely, there's a possibility of that. Or there's a possibility
and a pig's
that...
flying. Are you going to say something like that?
No, pigs fly. No, this
but
dumpster. No, but
like
I'm concerned.
So
like this
unlikely.
Dumpster thing is so concerning. Do people act? Is that like a thing that you have to do for fraternities?
It's a thing.
You
it's
went to
thing.
Those schools where you have to rush or whatever that's called.
Bree just said move on.
Anyway.